On the agenda tonight, we're going to be comparing the voice of Freddie Mercury back in 1975 to his voice now in 2022. Hello, Phil here from Wings of Pegasus, and welcome to another analysis video. If you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. So I am, of course, referring to the recent release of Face It Alone, where Freddie's voice had been put through pitch correcting software. We're going to be listening to the isolated vocal from Bohemian Rhapsody, so that was his voice back in 1975, and see if there are any differences. Of course, there will be. Just to give you fair warning, I am going to be jumping into this quite a lot, so if you want to listen to it the whole way through without me interrupting, as always, there's a link in the description below. So we're going to be focusing on Bohemian Rhapsody, of course, but I will reference that more modern version of Freddie's voice as well, just so we can contrast and compare. But let's get into it.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality.
So listening to the intro here, I mean, it's great that it's isolated. We can hear the way that it's been panned, and we can hear that it's lots of Freddie's voice put all over the place. But because we've got multiple takes going on, it means that the tightness, the accuracy of these notes is really accurate. I mean, it sounds like that, but what will happen is each voice is ever so slightly off the note, but then when you hear a collection of notes, because Freddie Mercury was so accurate vocally, but I mean pitch-wise, when you're hearing all of these pitches that are really close to the note, your ear takes the mean, the average, of what you're hearing. So that's why when you get a great vocalist and they're harmonizing with themselves, especially multiple takes, you get a really nice full sound. When it's panned like this, it's great as well, because you can hear them individually, but the notes just sound spot on. If you're wondering where the pitch monitoring software is, because there are multiple voices here, it obviously gets a little bit confused, so we just have to wait for Freddie to come in with his own vocal without any harmonies. But let's get back into it.
Open your eyes.
And interestingly there, we had a plosive on the mic, which is a quick release of air. I mean, it's what it sounds like, a plosive. When you make a P sound, you're holding back a lot of air, and then it escapes very quickly. When that air hits a microphone, it's not good news, because you get a plosive sound. And you can hear the air that Freddie's releasing hit the microphone. And this is why you have, you know, popper stoppers, popper filters, whatever you want to call them, in front of the microphone. And these are, I'm sure you've seen them, they're circular, and they have a thin material that is going to not allow air through, or at least it stops, it breaks up the air from plosives hitting the microphone, so you get an overall softer sound, which is going to sound better for your final recording. But it's interesting that even with this recording, as famous as it is, when the vocal's isolated, you can hear that air hitting the microphone, which isn't ideal, but it's just what happened, and you don't really notice it on the final recording.
Look up to the skies and see. I'm just a poor boy.
And again, I was waiting for, because I know poor is about to come up, another P. I was waiting to hear that, and you can hear a little bit of the air hit the mic as well.
I need no sympathy, because I'm easy come, easy go, little high, little low.
And just appreciating the panning going on there as well. But if you're listening to this on your phone or a tablet, you won't necessarily get these details, because it'll just be coming out of your phone just straight at you, rather than appreciating that stereo field. But, you know, interesting details to listen to how the voice has been produced in the studio.
Anyway, the wind blows doesn't really matter to me.
So, I mean, that's the first bit of isolated vocal without harmonies that we get. And of course, Freddie is bang on. I mean, he is sharp and then goes actually flat and then goes back up to the line. And then we've got this expression that gets lost when you start editing the voice. This glissando, this slide down. And it's not sliding down to a particular note.
Me.
It's me. It's kind of just let down there. Actually, me. He does kind of leave it close to that octave below, like that. But it's not being sung that way. It's not being a me and making it obvious like that. It's just an expression. I am going to reference the argument that a few people have made in the comment section on previous videos about how voices and the pitch of voices has been edited and corrected throughout the years with tape, with, you know, various speed and different ways of speeding up tape, slowing it down so that the vocalist is more accurate. And my argument against that has always been that that is still the voice you're working with. You're not putting the voice through a processor and then asking that computer to spit out a new voice that's being corrected. So I think even looking at this, we're going to have lines that are never going to be just on, you know, the line all the time. I'm talking about the pitch monitoring software on the right hand side. We're never going to get just lines straight on lines. We just actually touch it for a split second here, but we'll continue because it'll just emphasize my point.
Mama.
I mean, there we go. So the D4 or the D-flat, the C-sharp 4, it's the same note. We've got this. I mean, we should be at the D4. But the reason that I say D-flat 4 is because we're starting kind of just halfway between these two notes, the D4 and the D-flat. I'll just call it a C-sharp 4 so you guys can see, and the D4 here. We're between these lines, and it is clear as day that we're between these lines. But who, when listening to Bohemian Rhapsody, heard this first line and went, oh wow, that is so bad, it's actually between notes. That's how far he's actually missed it with this second part where the vibrato comes in. Nobody ever thinks that, and this is the point. Let me bring up on screen Freddie's voice in 2022, and it'll be on the left hand side. We've got, you can see, actually look at the line right at the top. If I, you know, actually don't go on it with my arrow, it appears, but you'll see how that's just stuck to a line. The next note underneath here, stuck to a line. Even the vibrato here has been placed directly over the line. So everything's conforming to 440 Hz tuning here, and everything is just bang on the line. And that's what's happening to his voice now because it's being edited. Whereas when we go back to this here being in between notes, this is how Freddie sang naturally. And even in the studio in 1975, where they still had the technology to shift the voice by adjusting the speed of the tape, it's still not giving us what we get with pitch correction. We get to hear it as it was. So it's because it's not put through a processor, that's the difference. You still hear the voice. Even if this was shifted, you know, a little bit sharp or a little bit flat, even though we're already quite flat, it would still have this variation, this starting up here and actually ending down here. You'd still get that expression. I mean, that's what this is. But with the pitch correction, it does it all in a line, and that's where you miss the expression. But anyway, as I said, you know, the proof is listening to the original and not noticing that it's actually between the notes.
Just killed a man.
And again, really nice slide here as well. That's the expression, as I said before, but we're still flat.
Put a gun against his head.
A little plosive here again.
Pulled my trigger, now he's dead. Mama.
And look, flat, and then in between notes with a vibrato.
Life had just begun.
And this is what you start to notice about Freddie's voice. When he goes into this lighter configuration in, I mean, it's a blend between falsetto and head voice. It's difficult actually to place what this is. Let me just take it back.
Life had just begun.
I mean, I'm inclined to say that's a head voice with air in the sound as well.
But now I've gone and thrown it all away.
And that proves it, because he was actually in that light head voice configuration and in the same phrase went down into chest voice. Let me take that back.
Life had just begun, but now I've gone and thrown it all away.
And that's something that you can't do with falsetto, is have a true falsetto sound and then bring it down into your chest voice. So, I mean, what I'm going to do is come back to me on screen. So when we've got this almost na na la la la, that's the sound which you can then turn into la 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 la, and you can start to lean in to chest voice. But the important point is that you can blend that with falsetto. It's a different register entirely and it works differently. So it means that you can't blend it with the lower part of your voice. It'll do a kind of flip as you go down. So yeah, interesting that, I mean, a lot of people would refer to that actually as falsetto, but it's not, it's just a head voice with air in the sound.
Mama!
And let me just grab this before it disappears. Started flat, went up to the note, actually vibratoed flat, and then we were sharp. So, I mean, it's great because it really does show you how inaccurate some of the most accurate voices of all time are and have been. So this is why when you're listening to autotune and pitch correction, it stands out like a sore thumb, because this is what a really accurate voice looks like. This is how inaccurate it is. And when we go back to what we saw before, this is too perfect. It's not the way that music works. It's not the way the expression works. But let's get back into it again.
Didn't mean to make you cry if I'm not back.
I mean, I love this, like now leaning into this. And the way that with his vibrato, I mean, we've got this really going sharp at the end of the phrase, but it's because when he's leaning into his voice, he's increasing the drama. Therefore, he's naturally now pushing his voice sharp, because it's not something that he's consciously thinking, oh, I want to be more dramatic now. So I'm going to intentionally add some rasp to my voice. And with that rasp, I'm going to go sharp because that's going to sound more dramatic. It's not something that works that way. This is just something that happens subconsciously when singers sing. It's just that when we can look at it in this detail, you start to notice that these are just common traits and common things that happen and make you feel a particular way when listening to a vocalist. You feel like it's more dramatic because of the way it's being delivered, but literally because of where the notes are being placed.
Again, this time tomorrow, carry on, carry on, as if nothing really matters.
And again, interesting to see that we're now consistently sharp, whereas before we were consistently flat. So it just goes to show that, you know, when you are singing, it's more about the expression, especially if you're a singer yourself. Focus on expression and get the notes to sound accurate. And I know that if you're learning to sing and you can't hit pitches at all, then it's good to just download this app, and it's called Vocal Pitch Monitor. It's an Android app. It's free. That's why I use it, because it's amazing in terms of its accuracy for plotting pitch. But is something that you guys can just download at home and get straight into learning to sing if you want to, and find where your voice is, even where you talk. If you talk into it and maybe talk like a robot so that it's just the same note all the time, you'll be able to see that moving on the screen, and you'll be able to see, oh, I talk at this particular pitch. And once you know that, you can then start to learn to sing. Just move where you're making that sound on the graph. Yeah, we've got this sharp, consistently sharp note going on, but it's because he's now leaning into it a little bit and having this vocal. We also get to appreciate the dynamics, the way that he starts, you know, leaning into it, but then at the end,
back again, this time
carry on.
Again, oh, it sounded like we had a little drop in there. So, but we've got this, again, head voice with air in the sound, but it sounds like we had a drop in. What I mean by that is, it's a vocal from another take that's just been put in right at the end, because it sounded a little bit unnatural going from one phrase into the next.
On, carry on.
Yeah, because going, carry on, his voice then interrupts his vocal, because nothing really matters.
Nothing really matters.
And it's, I mean, it's great, because the end note, this A sharp 3, the B flat 3, it sounds sharp, but it doesn't sound wrong. It's just got a little bit of something in there, a little bit of meaning. Being slightly sharper the note has given this a meaning that wasn't there before. If it was just straight on the line, it would just be straight on the line. It would be boring.
Time has come.
My time has come. And kind of letting that vibrato go down a bit.
Sends shivers down my spine. Body's aching all the time.
Yeah, and there's another little bit. I mean, I thought this is going to be a quick video tonight. Hopefully it's not going on for too long, but just listen to
body's aching.
The A, the way that he goes, body's aching. And that sound isn't a note. It doesn't register as a note.
He's aching all the time.
And then he comes back for the C4. That's the kind of thing that, with the pitch correcting software that was used on his voice for the latest release, that would have been shifted somewhere. Instead of going, body's eh, and just hearing eh, wherever that is, it would go, body's ache, eh, eh. It would come straight in on a note and therefore sound more mechanical. So this is the kind of thing that has been removed now.
Goodbye, everybody. I've got to go.
And again, when he's going up into this head voice with air in the sound, he's really accurate up there with that lighter vocal cord configuration. And by the way, when I say about things getting lost now and his words being snapped to notes where they weren't before, on, you know, the A or the beginning of aching, watch my other analysis videos to get an appreciation of that, because I do point out exactly where on the original recording session for Face It Alone, there's a bit of expression in Freddie's voice that was actually pitch corrected, and there was a particular part that was removed altogether.
Gotta leave you all behind and face the truth.
And again, because of the rasp, that note on face didn't register. But if you listen to it, you can hear that it's really not accurate at all.
Gotta leave you all behind and face.
It's actually really flat, going face. It's kind of down there.
It's the truth.
But then, like all great singers, he's got the expression in there so it stands out. He's just singing the way that he sings. And after that one note that was a little bit flat, he's now bang on the C4. And this is what great singers do. They are going to be sharp and flat, but they're consistently pitch perfect to the ears. With all of the manipulation they might have done with the tape to get it to, you know, be more accurate pitch wise, I don't think they did a lot with it, to be honest, because it is Freddie Mercury. And, you know, the other guys in the band are great singers in their own right as well, hitting pitches, being able to harmonise with Freddie. And we know that because of the live performances. But going back to just pitch correcting with tape, you can see on this that, I mean, not a lot of it's been done, but even if it had been done just here and there, how subtle it is that it's not changing the expression. We're not getting just a voice now being stuck on a line, because the voice isn't being processed. All of the lines that we're seeing, they're just effectively being moved. So you can't change that vocal phrase into a line, which is now something that with technology you can do. And that's why it sounds manipulated and it sounds false, because it wasn't the original expression that the singer sang into that microphone. It's what the singer sang into the microphone, put into a computer, squashed to a line, and then, you know, spat out again. So, I mean, that's the huge difference between the two. Obviously, all people in the studio now and producers have got to work with are these very old recordings of his voice, and it's just a shame that they are now putting it through a computer and we're hearing the result of that rather than just allowing his voice to remain as it was when he was in front of that microphone recording, as it is here with Bohemian Rhapsody. Thank you guys for, I mean, linking me to this in the first place and for requesting, suggesting videos in the comment section below. As always, keep doing that. Let me know what you guys think. And if you did enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. And I'll see you guys at the next one. Rock!